people would drive by, they look at us like we were crazy, and we were, although they were enjoying that there was no snow for about 30 yards. But I just want you to say, we were hard up. Yes, we were. We were hungry to play some touch football. Yeah. And the more intense our hunger, guess what? The more intentional the hunt.
Yeah.
And so when it comes to spiritual desire, there has to be the hunger.
Yeah.
There has to be the hunt. But also, I want you to know, if the hunger, when it comes to more of God, ever is coupled with a willingness to hunt, guess what will happen? God is a God. He's true to his word. Did you know that? And God will allow the God-given hunger for more of him, backed up with the hunting, to lead to what I want to call the having. Oh, bless the name of God. Because when it comes to the spiritual desire for intimacy with God, yes, more passion for God, more pursuing of God. But thirdly and lastly, and we'll wrap it up. Oh, I want you to know that it'll lead to some more power. Yes, it will.
Yeah.
Yes, it will. Yes, ma'am. Stick with me a few moments, okay? It will lead to more power from God. And would you go back to Psalm 27 one more time? Psalm 27, verse 4. The psalmist not only says, he says again, verse 4, what? One thing. Is that phrase? One more time. One thing. If I desire, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. That's always his phrase for the presence. Again, he was not talking about spending every day at the church building. That ain't what he's talking about. David understood that wherever God was, that's the house of the Lord. But now watch this. This is what he says. To do what? Behold. There we go. Do what? Behold the what? Beauty of the Lord. And to do what? To inquire in his temple. And the key word there is the word behold. And the idea, when he says, behold the beauty of the Lord, he is referring to gazing at something. He is referring to staring at something. He is referring to intently focusing. You see, there is a big difference in, did you know there's a big difference in gazing at something versus glancing at something? When you just glance at something, it probably doesn't affect you any. But did you know the more you gaze at something, not only do you want it more, have you found out that the more you do something, the longer it becomes a part of you? And the more you gaze at something, you start becoming like that. Is that right? And what this has to do with is more power from God. He says to behold the beauty of the Lord. And the good news today is that if we will ever begin to be hungry for more of the Lord, we begin to hunt for more of the Lord, we'll have more of the Lord. And when we have more of the Lord, I want you to know today, it is impossible now to draw closer to God and remain unchanged. What I'm just trying to say, it is impossible for the hunger on the inside to lead to some hunting on the inside. God says that he will make sure if we behold, when we have more of him, guess what? When we have more of God, guess what? God has more of us. And when God has more of us, guess what happens? We begin to change. Yes, we do, on the inside. God. If you don't believe me this morning, just as we talked about a few weeks ago, the prophet Isaiah. Isaiah had this face-to-face encounter with God. Yes, he ended up with some charred lips on the outside, but guess what? The charred lips on the outside meant there would be a change on the inside. If you don't believe me this morning, that it's impossible to draw near to God and remain unchanged, just ask Jacob. Do you remember Jacob? The Bible says that Jacob wrestled with God all night long, and the Bible says that Jacob was not making the progress that God wanted, and so God said, I got to get on out of here. And what God did, the angel hit Jacob in his hip to bring him down to himself. And the Bible says from that day forward, Jacob went around limping because he had this encounter with God. But though Jacob limped that day from the rest of his life, he was a conqueror with God. The limp on the outside. Sirs, notice there was a change in his walk on the inside. One more, Moses. Remember, Moses already had God, but one day Moses became hungry for more of God, and Moses said, Lord, show me your glory. Thank you for the miracle of the Red Sea. Thank you for the miracle of this and that, but I want more of you. And the Bible says that God said to Moses, I tell you what, my friend, you can't handle all that you asked for, but I will give you more than you had. The Bible says, not Bishop Jones, the Bible said, Moses, I'll hide you in the cleft of the rock. You can't handle all of me. But what I'll do, Moses, I'll let you see my backside. I got to protect you from the full force, but I'll hide you. And what I'll do is I'm going to come by. I'll remove my hand and let you see the backside of me. And the Bible says from that day forward, Moses, he didn't even know it. His face began to shine on the outside because of what had happened on the inside. And I believe the word of God with all my heart. Again, that God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. And I'm closing.
Yes. Wow.
You know, listen,
yes. And
I know that many of us, I didn't say many of you, I said many of us, there's some stuff we need to change, okay?
Yes.
God cares about your financial situation.
Yes.
God cares about your family situation. God cares about your future decisions you've got to make. God cares about all that's not right in your life. But I want you, this is what I believe with all my heart, this is God's pattern. This so often God wants to do more in us.
Yes.
Listen, before he does more for us.
Yes.
And if God does some changing on the inside, it don't matter what comes against me, glory to God, on the outside.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And so what God wants to do, he wants to change us from the inside out. But it all starts with a hunger for more of him, okay?
Yeah.
That has to get lined up with some hunting for him. Because I'm out of time again. Next week we'll look at what really hunting for him looks like. But I guarantee you, we'll let the hunger be followed up with the hunting. And let me just say this. The hunting just means it's not that mysterious. We just got to spend more private time with him, okay?
Yeah.
Next week, we just want to talk about how to spend private time with him. But lest I make this more mysterious than it is and more complicated than it is. Praise God that we spend time here publicly, but guess what? Real hunting. Real hunger. I'm talking about real hunger. Real hunger and real hunting, what is going to mean getting on up when you don't feel like getting up? Getting on down in prayer when you don't feel like getting on down in prayer? Being willing to hunt him. And when we hunt him, we'll have him. And when we have him, he'll have us. And when he has us, he'll change us. Nothing is more important after salvation than a deep-seated longing for more of Christ. Father God, thank you that you love us. Thank you for how much you care for us. Thank you, Lord God, and we're just praying. Thank you for saving us. We're just so grateful for your saving us. Thank you for the one thing of the certainty of salvation. But we just beg you to, first of all, grant us a deep-seated hunger for you, more of you. We acknowledge, we're just so grateful that we do have you. We really are. But would you give us a hunger, Lord, for more of you? And then help us to be willing to seek you like never before, especially in our private time with you. And we just thank you, Lord God, as we gaze upon you. We'll become more like you. It's in your name we pray, and we ask it all. Can all of God's people say amen? Amen. Amen.